Hey everyone, this is Copic Tips. I am going to be making a video about how to color galaxy or outer space designs with Copics, but first I'd just like to say that I bet a lot of you are wondering if I'll be doing a 100 subscriber giveaway. I will not be doing it for 100 subscribers, but I am planning on doing a giveaway for 200 subscribers. So get the number up there, guys, and we'll get our giveaway. 200 subscribers, I'll be doing a giveaway. Now to the tutorial. I've been playing with a couple different types of galaxies. This is not intended to look like a heart, but it ended up looking like that, so whatever. And I perfected one, this middle purpley one. So I'm just gonna teach you guys how to make this one, and then if I can work out the kinks in these two, then I will bring that to you guys as well. So let's get started.
The marker combinations that I use to make this galaxy, they don't really look like they'd blend very well, but trust me, they do. So it's BV quadruple zero, pale thistle, BV 20 dull lavender, BV 01 viola, BV 25 grayish violet, BV 08 blue violet, and V 99 aubergine, and then 100 black. So yeah. I also am using a piece of Strathmore mixed media paper, which is my preferred Copic paper. So that's the materials.
All right, so here we go. I'm gonna start out with my BV quadruple zero. That's BV with four zeros. And I'm just going to make the general outline of where I want my galaxy thingy to be. So it's gonna be about that size, and now I'm just gonna go in wherever I want the middle of it, and it could be slightly off-centered, so I'm putting mine a little bit more to this side so it looks like an eyeball looking in one direction. It could be directly in the center, wherever you want it. Then I'm gonna take my BV20, my next color, and I'm just gonna do a ring around it, and since it's off to one side, the ring is gonna be larger on one side than it is the other. And you want to go a little bit bigger than it should be so that you have room to blend over onto the next color with. Then I'm just going to go around in a circle for a little bit around where the two colors meet, and that'll sort of create its own color in that area. Go around the areas that are still pretty light. You want it nice and dark on their border. There you go. Next we're going to put in some... Oh, and I was just blending that with my lightest color, by the way. You're always going to blend with your lighter color in the two. I'm gonna go with my BV01 next, and I'm just gonna do a ring here, which is sort of turning it from a pinky blue to more purple. Make it bigger on this side, and making it bigger on one side than the other will give it a sense of dimension, so it'll look as though it's almost a black hole, which could suck something in one direction like that. Then I'm gonna take my BV20, lightest color out of these two, and do the same thing. We're gonna do a ring around where the two colors meet. And you don't want a perfect blend here, because you want all the colors to be distinct. You sort of want the rings. Next we're going to go with BV25, which is a huge color jump, but it'll work out in the end, just trust me. So a bit thinner on one side than the other. We're gonna do a pretty big area of this, because now we're starting to blend from the galaxy thingy to blackness for space. So then we'll go with my BV01, and we're just gonna do the ring again. No relation to the movie The Ring. And this time, because the color is so much drastically lighter, I want to go over all of the BV25 with it as well, so it doesn't lighten it along the border. So there's that color put down, and now I'm going to take my BV08, put it just along the edge. You're not going to do any sense of dimension with this color. This is just a color to help along the blending, but we are going to blend this color in as well. And now I'm starting to reach the border there of my edge of my black hole thing, which is just about right. If you don't reach your border, that's perfectly fine. We're going to be going over the whole outside area with black anyway. So yeah, it doesn't really matter. And now at this point, we're about to make the jump into our V99 and our 100 black. So I'm going to take my BV with four zeros and just go over the whole thing really quickly, doing my circular motions. I don't want to rest it there too long, otherwise it'll start to lighten up the colors, and I don't want that. I just want to blend it in a little bit more. And remember, this is a really freeing thing to draw because of how it's out of nature, so it's not all perfect and square and detailed. It's really just a blob, and it's individuality. However you want it to look, that's how it'll look on your paper. You don't need to have it look exactly like mine. You could use greens for all I care. I mean, it's your vision, so if that works for you, that works for you. Next, we'll take V99 and do another ring. We're not actually gonna do an area with this color because this is just to help it go into the black. And we're not gonna blend this one out. I want it to overlap a little bit more on mine, so I'm gonna actually have it cover up a lot of the BV08. And then there you go. Now for our 100 black. I'm not gonna color my whole page black because that'd be a huge waste of ink. I'm just gonna do a little area around this black. So we're gonna start off. Just doing a border here. And for those of you who it's really scary to them to do big Copic backgrounds for fear of like messing up the shade or whatever, I used to be one of you people. And then I just sort of calmed down, relaxed, and just went nice and evenly. And it sort of became easier for me. I'm also going to be making a tutorial on how to use pastels on Copic art to do backgrounds later. So you can watch that as well if doing big backgrounds really terrifies you. And what I'm doing now is just taking my V99 and going along the edge of the black just to smoothen it out. And you really want to go along the edge here so you don't have like a white halo around this. Now we're nearly done. We're just going to take our black and color a big ol' area around the black hole, which will be outer space. Do as many of these as you want, however big the sizes are, whatever your purpose for needing to draw one of these is, just do that. I like to think of my channel as a place to find tutorials for Copics that you wouldn't really find in other places on the internet. Oh, and oops, I just messed up, but that's not really a problem at all with this, because that's what this whole like strategy thing, like this whole concept is. So I'm just gonna work with it now and like make it work here, and then I'll take my BV01. If you do something similar, you're probably not as disorganized and messy as I am, so you probably won't. But if you do, just do what I'm doing and make it work. Make it work with the picture. Because the truth is, when you make a mistake, I like to think that it's like, I don't know, God's way or something of helping us along to create something even better. Maybe I'll just add in one of those there. I doubt this will be that much better, but who knows. So we'll just add it in. A little bit of the color. And I'm just going with BV01 and BV00 again, just going over these areas. Then we'll just continue on with the black, and you'll just keep going with the black until you're contented with how it looks. Now the final step is to take a couple jelly rolls. For this I'll be using a silver shooting star jelly roll and a metallic silver jelly roll. I'd recommend using at least one of these two, preferably metallic silver. That's the one I use for stars. This one's just to add a little bit of shine. I'm sorry, before we do that, we're actually going to take a colorless blender refill, and this part is optional. A colorless blender refill, and all we're going to do is, drop the cap. All we're going to do is a couple dots right in the middle here, and it'll sort of send the color out. And it gives this sort of cool aurora borealis effect. Just do it wherever you want, and it's really just a crazy sort of mess, really. I mean, that's what outer space is. So then, I'm gonna let this dry, and I'll come back to the video once it is dry. So it's pretty much dry now, and it looks pretty cool. Yeah, so there's the two different. In this one, I did not use the colorless blender refill, and in this one, I did. So pick your preference. And now for the part, if you made any mistakes, this is where they won't matter anymore. Just grab one of your jelly rolls. I prefer to do the majority of my stars with the metallic silver one, but do them whatever you want. And I start by putting in like a couple big stars. I like to do sort of three big stars, maybe four in one area. Then I'll go in with some medium ones. Now some small ones, which is just a single dot. And you really want a lot of stars. And it doesn't matter if you sort of touch it down, then it flicks up a little bit. Because it's outer space, and there's shooting stars, and there's meteors, and it's your art. And this is a really freeing thing to draw. So honestly, if someone doesn't like the way you're drawing outer space, or if someone doesn't like the way you're drawing anything, really, this should be just a rule for life. If someone doesn't like something that you're drawing, say, "All right, that's great. How do you draw it?" And then you can be like, "Oh, whatever." Because people who can't put their money where their mouth is, I think should shut up. And now we'll go in with our next marker, or pen. We're just going to do a couple. Now, this is a really strong color. It's a really bright one when put on light areas. So I'm just going to do a little bit. Scattered hither and yon. Oh god, I just said hither and yon. And there you go. That's how you do an aurora borealis. Just like that. So, thanks guys. Ciao for now.